This is the NFL on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's the Eagles going up against the Steelers. So let's get you up to the Steel City. Standing by in Pittsburgh, here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. As he takes this up near the 25. Mike Mitchell coming up from the secondary to make the stop. And a peek at the offense. And Matthews, a guy that we have to talk about.
Jordan Matthews, Brandon, is an anomaly. Normally a long receiver plays outside. He likes to work out of the slot. Does a terrific job absorbing punishment and catching the football.
Forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. And a look at the Steelers' defensive unit.
Lawrence Timmons comes from a long line of productive Florida State players. And when I say productive, I usually mean spectacular.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
Here's Wentz to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. So on fourth down, here's the veteran left-footed punter Donnie Jones to kick it away. Back deep for the Steelers, Antonio Brown. Catch taken back near about the 36-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there. No return. And the Steelers will go on offense here. First and 10.
Hey, tight end's right. Watch tight end. Three down. Let's go.
Now Roethlisberger on first down. He's got time. Still back there. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. It's caught inside the 25. It's a big play. Roethlisberger around 43 yards. Fresh set of downs here.
There's no doubt about it. That's just one of the best connections in the league. Big Ben throwing it to Antonio Brown. And Antonio Brown has turned himself into such a player. A low-round draft pick. But you can't beat his determination or work ethic. And Big Ben welcomes that.
And Big Ben won a Super Bowl at 23, youngest ever to do so, has never looked back. Good throw, receiver does his job, and it's a first down for the offense.
Excellent execution all the way around. Plenty of time for the quarterback and the receiver to work their first down magic.
Hey, guys, check me out,
All right, here we go.
From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And the sack leads to roughly a loss of six, and it brings up second and goal.
Tight end's on the loose.
Here's the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about three. Time for the offensive starters now for the Pittsburgh Steelers, and a guy to watch out wide, Sammy Coates.
A slow start in his rookie season, only caught one pass in 2015. They're expecting much bigger things from him, trying to help out that offense. If he can get open, you know his quarterback will find him.
Tight end to the left. Tight end left.
A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger looking for someone to throw to. Escaping the pressure right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Fletcher Cox in there to make the play. It'll be a loss of 14, and it'll bring up a fourth down. So on fourth down, the Steelers call on the number of Chris Boswell for the field goal try. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And Boswell's kick is good. And the Steelers will jump out to a 3-0 lead. So the folks here in the stands this afternoon, they're happy about that one. Their guys get the early advantage after the opening drive field goal.
And they should be happy. Their guys look good getting down the field, and that's got to give them hope that good things are in store here today.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20. As his guys will set up shot at the 23-yard line. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some.
Now let's go! Green, 39!
On first down, Wentz. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. Matthews the intended target, and it's second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down.
You got three. Three down. Three down.
They come up in an offset eye.
Green, 39.
Hey, watch the slip.
It's a toss right. Ryan Matthews. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
You have to give big-time credit to the cornerback on that play. Most of them like to just sit back and say, I'm playing pass. But he diagnosed that play so fast and got into the backfield for a loss of yardage, that's a monster play by a corner.
Offense needs 11. Have to think pass here on third down.
Hey, hey, hey. You got three.
Here we go now. 3-19. 3-19.
94 is the mic. 94 is the mic.
The play clock's running down. Now Wentz. He targets Jordan Matthews, and it's caught. The pickup of 11, and it moves the chains. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
Some space here, and he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
Dance class, anyone? Did you see the steps between the quarterback and the running back?
That's what you need for a good counter.
You have to have it, because you're setting up your blocking. There's a timing element as well, but they have to marry up their steps. Otherwise, that timing gets thrown out the window.
Timing was great there and a big run. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Three down.
Set!
94 is the mic.
Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're not doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
Second down following the run. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Now Wentz throwing on second down. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
Tight right, tight right.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Gonna go is a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Stephon Tua came out of Notre Dame as another one of those really tall defensive ends, and you just wonder, would they be able to have the leverage to bend and make plays? I think he just gave us an answer with that tackle.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Let's go, Mike 50. Mike 50.
And to give this time to the tailback. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Partner into the second quarter, and I guess you can kind of look at it both ways. The offense, they've got to figure out what they're going to do because they haven't scored any points. But if you're the defense, you're feeling great about what you've got going on. The only concern you have, if you get to the half, what adjustments will the offense make to try to defeat you? The Steelers insert their nickel defense on third down.
Yeah, they add a DB.
Man, I got you.
Time running out here on the play clock. The throw is Wentz, and that is incomplete. He was looking for Dorial Green-Beckham, and it's fourth down.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he's able to bat it away.
So now on fourth down, the Eagles will hand things over to their field goal kicker, and that's Caleb Sturgis. From the left hash, this from 39. And Sturgis able to knock it through, and that will tie us at 3-3. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. He'll start out on the ground with Bell. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's 2nd and 12. So with that, we come upon the 2-minute warning here on the NFL on EA Sports.
Hey, we've got tight left, tight left, tight end's left.
On second down, Roethlisberger. Man open right side, it's Rodgers. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
They'll come out in the pistol. From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. Give him three on the play. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
Hey, check, check. Let's go,
let's go. They'll run it with Bell. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Call it a gain of 5. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down.
We got three.
Three down.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Look at the time. Now he's going to go up top over the middle. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You can feel the anguish all the way up here. It certainly looked like he had that one in the end zone. Open. Unable to hold on to it.
Hey, hey, hey. We got three. We got three. Three down. Three down. 58th Mike. 58. 58th Mike.
They're going to run this with a tight end. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. So a ways to go here on third and 10. Brown, the lone receiver left. On third down, Roethlisberger. He's got time in the pocket. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now let's see. Yeah, the offense still out there. They elect to go on fourth and 11. Here we go on fourth down with Roethlisberger. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. Ten. Here's Wentz. Ertz over the middle. Okay, give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
Here we go now.
Wentz to throw on second down. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Lawrence Timmons. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about it in the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
Three down.
Set! Black five!
58 to the mic! 58 to the mic!
After the interception, here's Roethlisberger. Throw complete there, Rodgers. And he'll take this one up to about the 6-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
Four down. Check. Four down.
Blue 30.
And 58 is
a mic. On second down, it's Bell. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the eight. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. They go play action here on first down. And his throw here's incomplete. The shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Man open right side, it's Rodgers. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. Throw left side is complete to Rodgers. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger surveying the field, going for the deep ball, and it's caught. It's Brown. Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown, 40 yards, and the Steelers have taken the lead. Up and it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. That's fielded in the end zone. Pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
5 yards on the catch there brings up second down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is. And I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
On the ground with a tight end. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. A 3-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. Third down now following the run.
Watch tight end. Key him. Key the tight end.
All right, here we go. 319! 319!
On third and short to give to the tight end. It's a gain of just a couple there, but it's enough to get him the first. Quickly. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. James Harrison, the veteran, in on the stop. To go here on 2nd down.
Here we go now. 319. 319.
Play clock winding down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. It's in a little bit of a bind here. 9 yards to go on 3rd down. Back now in Pittsburgh. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the 4th quarter. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now Wentz on 3rd down. Aguilar has it. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic. So anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra at the end with a short run.
Offense tight, comes tight, to the line left, now, first tight, and tight, 10. Left. Short gain there down to the 37-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. So the offense looking at a second and 8. The play clock's running down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down.
Hey, hey, hey. We got three. Three down.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Time running out here on the play clock. Throwing now is Wentz. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
And he still doesn't have a catch. We're into the second half. I think it's a little bit of a surprise to me, but that was one he should have caught.
Absolutely. That was his best opportunity right there. He dropped it.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This officially a 55-yard attempt. That's on target, but it's no good. He had it online, but it came up just shy of the crossbar. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, he's got a big leg, and when everything comes together, he can certainly hit from long range, but this one's going to come up just a little bit short. A very good effort, though.
They come up with one running back. That's Bell. And they'll give it to him here. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage if they try to bleed it out.
Again, it's Bell. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and 2 more.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Third and 2. Now Roethlisberger is going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Le'Veon Bell, kiss him goodbye. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell, 47 yards. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. And he's able to put it through. And this is going to be roughing the kicker, an inexcusable penalty, Charles.
You've worked so hard to hold him to a 3-point kick. Now you give him the ball again with a chance for a touchdown.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line. And now the Eagles offense back out onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Philadelphia.
Dorial Green Beckham taking it in. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score.
And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And it's up through the goalposts. It's 17-10. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They'll go again with Bell. And he is going to lose. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back.
Hey, we've got tight left, tight ends left. Even, four,
yeah,
even.
Like 20. Roethlisberger to throw. He finds Coates complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now hang on here, timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Now a first down carry by Bell. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. What a big-time play there.
And this one caught by Coates. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
On third down, here's Bell. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Oh, Roethlisberger going to throw. Going up top. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. He had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
Finding time. And he fends him off. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the offense will get the ball back and be touchdown. And with that, this game is over. Really a great game that we just saw. Charles, interesting ending, that's for sure. You don't usually see a fumble on the final play of the game, but they were just trying to do whatever they could to get in the end zone. They coughed it up.
I think you're exactly right on that. You do what you have to do to try and win the game. They gave it a shot. You're exactly right about a fumble, then to finishing the game, getting the recovery. Wow, a strange ending, but a heck of a game overall.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from Heinz Field.